ICICI Bank Commercial Banking present Business World International Business Awards. Celebration Partner, Teachers Origin, Process Advisor, PwC, Event Partner, FISMAY, Television Partner, NDTV Profit.
I think the dynamics of trade is going to see significant change over a period of time. So clearly big markets, which are US, Europe, which today account for a large percentage of our export. For example, from the software side, it's almost, I'm told, 80-85% goes to these countries. Clearly these are big markets, but at the same time, these are developed, matured, and growth potential is sort of fairly limited. To that extent, clearly the growth is going to come from sort of countries which are emerging countries, emerging economies. And clearly the business strategy for sort of our play in both this segment of market has to be different. The kind of product, the kind of services which will be required by some of these developed countries which were hitherto our sort of main destination for export will require a different mindset sort of to sort of continue there and grow that business. Because clearly one of the things that we are seeing is a lot of companies from these countries are also looking at our domestic market to sort of achieve their growth numbers. So for example, GE recently announced that almost 60% of their turnover going forward has to come from emerging economies. So clearly it's a two-way process which is going to work, and it's going to be that much more difficult to sort of grow our share of business in these countries. So for growth, clearly the companies have to look at the markets which are yet to be fully mined. And to that extent, we are already seeing a trend where we are seeing new potential in Africa, in Latin America. And clearly these countries, the growth what they will offer and accordingly the size what they will achieve over a period of time is going to be huge, but we need to invest in them very clearly. So in terms of finance objective, what we try to tie up for these two segments has to be completely different. For example, in developed countries, there are a lot of opportunities in terms of innovation. We are seeing a lot of companies from India now looking for non-recourse financing to actually reduce their balance sheet, sort of debt levels to actually to have improved their cash flows, improve their earnings from the export, and they are able to in a way achieve a financing which is with either very limited recourse to them or with no recourse to them, because the buyer happened to be from the countries which are developed countries, and many times they are the reputed corporates. There are also a lot of other financing structures which is being used by a lot of exporters. For example, back-to-back letters of credit, financing in terms of commodity financing. These are essentially the sort of characteristics of a trade finance market which is well developed, wherein most of the financing is divorced of the balance sheet. It is something which is looked at as financing for the transaction, financing for the trade, and clearly I see a lot of opportunities for Indian exporter to these countries to move from predominantly a balance sheet led financing to transaction and sort of cash flow led financing. And I can see clear movement towards that. I am seeing a lot of Indian corporates trying to do that successfully, transactions which are non-recourse in nature. But if you move to the countries which are the countries of growth, countries of future prospect for Indian corporates, clearly the challenges are completely different. There, the focus moves clearly from sort of your balance sheet risk to clearly the risk of your transaction. And there are many companies who, while getting into these countries, do not realize that financing cost could be a significant percentage of their transaction. So unless that is clearly budgeted in terms of their pricing, it could have significant impact on the overall profitability of the deal. So clearly there are a lot of multilateral agencies which are coming forward to support trade from various countries into the countries which are not so well rated. And with the support of some of these multilateral agencies, it is possible to structure your trade finance solutions which are much more sort of cost effective and which meet your risk requirement.